under Don Revie. They've only been beaten once, but that the one they had to win. Or at least had to avoid defeat in Czechoslovakia. Francis with the free kick. Pearson! Blocked by Pat Rice, who I think knew little about it. Shot on the turn from Pearson as it came up to him. We're looking at it from Pat Jennings' viewpoint. And it hit Pat Rice. It wasn't, in fact, Pat Rice. But it was cleared. Taylor. Shannon once more taking a wide position. And Todd again up on the attack. Pearson. Did well! And Francis over the top! Lovely turn by Stuart Pearson, but the skipper unable to take advantage of it. But a real cool piece of play, good control on the line, and a lovely weighted cross that Jerry Francis really didn't make the most of. He arrived a little bit late and couldn't get up above to nod it down. That proves the point. In the opposite direction, here's McElroy. Half a chance for the shot, he didn't take advantage of it. Here's Spence. Mills with him, driven across, save with the legs of Clements from Hamilton. Good reaction by the England keeper. Certainly the best attack the Northern Ireland have put together. McElroy finding space at the start and Clements denying Hamilton at the end. Here's Spence who cut him from the right, an awkward cross, Hamilton shot and turned away by the right heel of Ray Clements. Becoming a bit of an old story, and a goal could change it quite a lot. England in need of a goal for their confidence. But they must be getting to wonder when it's coming to, and it comes now! And so close by Pearson! What a lovely header! Look at this one from Kevin Keegan. As the ball is floated up, little back header, and Pearson past the far post by a whisker. Kennedy, Mills, that's useful, comes to Francis, must be now, it is! Nicely built attack, and England have got the breakthrough. Bill Taylor applauds, Don Revie doesn't move a muscle, but he knows how important that goal must be. Scored by the England skipper, a good move this, a nice ball by Mills forward for Shannon, the touch for Francis running in on it, round the goalkeeper and poking it home. Shannon, and you'll never walk alone going up. Here's Kennedy, Sammy Nelson across the back, but only to Shannon. That's nice, and it's a penalty. No doubt in the referee's mind. Tortuous run. And Cassidy looking dejected. Came in, Shannon in control of the ball, and no doubt at all that that was a penalty. And it's Mick Shannon who's going to take it against Pat Jennings. And very comfortably 2-0. And the whole complexion now has changed. Pat Jennings going the wrong way. Hamilton. Nicol with no player in front of him. Except some 30 yards away. Now they're a bit closer. Query, nice touch to McElroy from Cassidy, good try. Good play between the three, McCreary, Cassidy and McElroy. Prepared to hit it first time. McCreary's little touch, the first time ball through the gap. McElroy running onto it, taking it in his stride, hitting with the right as Clements came out and wide of the far post. Kennedy. Keegan making a run out to the left. Well, he might well be playing quite a bit for the rest of the game. Setting up the cross, Pearson, Taylor rather, Kennedy, good save, Pearson! Pearson picking up the rebound, Pat Jennings looking very disappointed. And so Stuart Pearson gets his first goal for England. There to pick up the rebound, it was Taylor who knocked it back. Kennedy battling for it with Clements. As it came off Pat Jennings, Pearson poking it wide of the prostrate goalkeeper. Todd. Massive England players forward, Pearson and Francis in each other's way. Well won by Todd. Keegan. Shannon. Four. His second. Move started by Todd, ended by Mick Shannon. And England now got one better than the Scots. Good battling there by Todd. Here's the cross. Keegan, the first effort, and then it came wide to Shannon, who took his time, let Jennings dive past him, and then put it again behind the keeper. Three Irish players on the 18-yard line. Cassidy being policed by Colin Todd. The action of a winning team rather than a losing one. England throw. And it does not need to be taken. 4-0, the final outcome. A performance which has to be seen in the light of the opposition. But 4-0 it is. Mick Shannon getting two of them. The other goal scored by Jerry Francis, who got the important opener. And Stuart Pearson. More has been learned, and victory and goals are the greatest boost for confidence that any football manager can find.